Welcome to our midday devotions brought to you by St. Anne's Anglican Church, Fox Hill, New Providence, from the Holy Hill. I am Director Archdeacon Hugh Bartlett. May we pray. Almighty God, the giver of all good gifts, in your divine providence, you have appointed various orders in your church. Give your grace, we humbly pray, to all who are called to any office and ministry for your people, and so fill them with the truth of your doctrine and clothe them with holiness of life, that they may faithfully serve before you to the glory of your great name and for the benefit of your holy church, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 3, verses 4 through verse 7. For when one says, I belong to Paul, and another, I belong to Apollos, are you not all too human? What then is Apollos? What is Paul? Servants through whom you came to believe as the Lord assigned to each. I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the growth. So neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. The word of the Lord. Today we are within the Embertide, and today is an Ember Day. Ember Days are observed as special days of prayer for those who serve the church in various ministries. Both ordained and lay, and for vocations. In our diocese, in the Bahamas and Turks and Caicos Islands, we have traditionally observed Ember Days as the Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays within the weeks after the third Sunday of Advent, the first Sunday of Lent, Pentecost Sunday, and the Sunday of the octave of the Feast of the Exaltation of the Holy Cross in September. In our reading from 1 Corinthians 3, we hear Paul responding to a growing trend in the Corinthian congregation. Some parishioners were acknowledging that they had a favorite preacher, which perhaps is something of a natural inclination. Individuals have different preferences. Some individuals sound different as they preach. People look different and use different words and various styles of speaking and styles and how fast they speak and how fluid they speak and so forth. One preacher may therefore reach someone in a way another preacher could not, for whatever reason. It may just be the preference of the individual. I believe it is good because that seems to lend itself to reaching more individuals. However, if persons are idolizing a particular preacher, that is a problem. Hence, we hear Paul in 1 Corinthians 3 and 6. I planted, Apollos watered, and God gave the growth. Ultimately, all Christian ministries belong to God, and we are called to share in God's work. So allotting ourselves or assigning ourselves to someone other than God creates for some an issue. So Paul continues in 1 Corinthians 7 So neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. And so, my friends, my prayer is that more of us will be able to identify our life's work within the kingdom of God. May God bless you in this day as you reflect on your journey, as I reflect on mine, and have a wonderful day. Please share this as widely as possible. Thank you.